While I had used Linux before that, it was summer of 2023 when I started to get more into it and try it over Windows. Linux comes in a lot of distributions, and here at the end of 2024, I'm still switching between them, not being sure what to use. I'd like to not distro hop very much, mainly because the switch takes a bit of time. I'd have to back up my personal stuff, go through with the actual installation, retrieve my backed up files and set up the programs I need over time. Distro switch is like starting from a clean page. Some of my personal stuff may still get lost with the removal of the previous system. Well, what am I looking for? I'd like a rather easy to use desktop. Software should be recent because newer stuff comes with its improvements and the graphical interface looks nicer and is more functional. I'd also expect good program support. I'll just say here that the Debian family seems tempting because it has plenty of helpful packages. Good support and many programs are provided for that, even as they packages off the internet. I would like it to be reliable and my programs would just work. Freezes, crashes and breakages aren't ideal. The desktop environment certainly matters for me. I like an updated GNOME or KDE Plasma, though I tend to be more on the KDE side. So now I will say a few words about the distros I have installed. Ubuntu was what introduced me to Linux, but the current state just isn't what it used to be. Ubuntu wants to do things their way and really forces their app format snap, which is kinda quirky on desktop Linux. I wouldn't consider it as user-friendly as it once was compared to the alternatives. It also isn't as reliable as it may have been or as one could expect. I have run into errors. Fedora is what I tried next. It is alright. Programs do get updated there. It is not Debian based, but more on the Red Hat side. It is still pretty easy to get programs, and for those not supported natively on Red Hat systems, I could maybe find a way around. Fedora provides a pretty vanilla environment. You get a graphical interface with its respective apps, and not much else added on it. Yeah, that seems good. Desktop comes like it's supposed to be used, and you can do what you want with that. One thing here is setting it up. The installer has an interesting layout. Fedora is keen on supporting free and open source software, so for any proprietary stuff, including drivers and multimedia codecs, you have to go online and get additional repositories. The main edition with GNOME Desktop seems slightly easier to set up. There is some handholding like, would you like to enable third-party repos and Flatpak? But not everything gets set up that way either. Fedora seems to be really forward-looking, like how they have remote support for XOR display. This is how I managed to break the drivers of my current installation by trying to set up KDE Plasma on XOR and AMD GPU drivers. I found a way around the issue for now, but let's see how it goes. Linux Mint is really beginner friendly. It is based on Ubuntu with Snap completely replaced among other refinements. It comes with its own set of graphical tools, such as a software manager that is packed with programs. However, its default look and the cinnamon desktop is not for me. You can install another desktop on it, but you're not really supposed to do that, and I run into error messages like that. It is based on long-term support Ubuntu, so it does get outdated after a while. The performance also doesn't seem the best. Debian, the OG. It is what Ubuntu and Ubuntu-based distros are based on. It's kinda like Ubuntu without its mess. The stable release puts the packages through a long freeze period, meaning that they are at least months old by the time a new version of Debian releases, and only the most important security updates are added. So you can see it's rather slow moving for me. Look at the graphical interface, it's a GNOME 43, which looks old, and Plasma 5. So while Fedora has forced applications in the repos, Debian, for more sensitive applications, includes those with long life cycles, where they get security updates with minimal changes. That's why Firefox ESR is there and not the standard Firefox web browser. If you need something with another kind of release cycle, you're gonna have to find a different way to install it. Debian stable seems stable, but I didn't say it's without any issues. There is also Debian testing, a development environment for the next Debian release. So yes, more recent packages. I'll just say that because these are programs slowly prepared for the next edition and they aren't of equal impact, there is some mismatch between them. For example, the first time I tried it, the glow of the sub was like half 44, half 45. Considering all the visual changes in version 45, that was looking pretty odd. A recent example, I think they haven't fully upgraded the KDE Plasma 6, because when I tried transition from stable to testing, I couldn't see any programs in the lists. I recently realized some programs just disappear from testing because they are flawed and then they just wait for an update. Because the updates come from another edition after a testing period, testing is notorious for critical updates being delayed. And I have run into bugs on testing. I'd assume mostly on KDE desktop. Maybe I could try Debian Seed for a more consistent experience. Well, I tried OpenSUSE once. It still comes in different editions. The main one, Tumbleweed, is rolling release. This means that the software is updated continuously. There are no point releases every 6 months where you have to upgrade to another. I like the green theme that's on KDE Plasma. The system is not based on Debian, instead using a more obscure package manager. A selling point of the distro, so to speak, is Yast, a suite of system administration tools, and yet OpenSUSE feels maybe a little too technical for me. Kubuntu is literally Ubuntu, but with a KDE Plasma environment. It is certainly more usable than vanilla Kubuntu. Discover KDE Software Manager is good for installing dev programs and flatpaks. Still, it's centered around snaps, no escape from that, and there's no remedy for programs that are forced snaps. So on Linux I run into some audio stuttering on heavier programs over time, but audio crackling is especially a problem for me on Kubuntu. Out of the distros I've installed and actually tried to use, KDE Near is the one I've used the least. For a grand total of 2 days, tried it once. It is more of a testing environment for KDE developers having the latest KDE software on Ubuntu LTS. This mix of two release cycles might make updating interesting. I've run into issues with the interface itself, such as some settings not saving as I recall. Maybe a little more about the issues on the next distro. It is Tuxedo OS. I made a whole video about my impressions with that, but basically it is the OS of a German computer manufacturer. It is based on KDE Neon, which is a bit worrying. So it is ultimately based on LTS Ubuntu, on which the latest KDE environment from KDE Neon is then applied. And on top of that, Tuxedo Enterprise adds some of their own improvements, like an updated kernel with a few fixes. It's good to have an actual dedicated company look after the distro, but it really is a mix of old and new software. Getting the desktop from KDE Neon, a development environment, there are some bugs with the graphical interface, such as apps not using the right style. In the video, I mentioned having a different kind of audio issue, as I didn't have any sound in VirtualBox. Turns out, it was an issue with sound output that also affects Audacity, where the sound either goes to HDMI by default or does not work at times. This also affects some other distros on the Ubuntu tree, just that it was especially noticeable and pressing on Tuxedo OS. Well, I know some are quite excited about Arch Linux, by the way, but right now, as a casual user, not a chance. Well, one option is to go back to mainly using Windows 11, but considering I'm trying Linux distros over Windows in the first place, I might not be very comfortable under Microsoft's influence either. Windows 11 has things like spyware, adware, Microsoft pushing their own stuff, other kinds of performance issues. Windows 10 looks bland on top of that. So let's be content about me having interest in Linux. I may have focused more on the issues I have with the distros and what pushes me away, but there is certainly plenty of good in them too, and going to 2025, I think I will stay on Linux, try to tame it, make it work for me. The distros I currently steer more towards are Mint, Fedora, and some form of Debian. As I hinted, I am currently on Fedora, I'll see how I'll feel about staying on that, and where this Linux adventure will take me. So I guess I will end this talk here. If you were interested, you can perhaps leave a like and subscribe for more computer content. Thank you for being here and happy holidays to you all. I will be back next year here on the Media Lane channel, so see you then.